Next thing, what I would suggest is do not let your sickest plant dictate the grow. Once you create your schedule, and in your schedule, you're going to have your watering schedule, your feeding schedule, what you're going to be giving your plants. You're going to be increasing your nutrients at different times. All those different things are going to be dictated in your schedule. So if you have a sickly plant, so often the squeaky wheel gets the grease. And what I mean by that is your best plant, because it's growing so well and it's not needing the attention, so often we put our extra time into the plants that are most sickly. Let's even think about it with our own kids. The kid that is reading and doesn't have any problems versus the kid that's jumping all over and annoying us. Which kid ends up getting your attention? The one you end up screaming at to stop jumping on the couch versus the kid that's just sitting on its own reading, you're not giving him any attention. And you might not think that that's a big deal, but when you constantly keep giving attention to someone that really doesn't deserve it, and you don't give attention to a person that's not asking for it but does need attention, what that ends up being called is neglect. And so what happens is you're neglecting your most valuable plant that's going to give you the highest return on investment, or your crop, because I've seen so often a small portion of the grow doesn't do well, and the grower completely forgets about 80% of its return on investments and tries to recover that small 20% and ends up destroying the whole grow. He ends up losing all of his money, all of his return investment, his time, everything, just because he couldn't make the hard decision on saying, enough's enough. I'm not going to put up with this abuse. I don't want you around me. Get out of my grow room. And you literally just take your sickly pants and remove them from your grow room if you aren't someone that can make the hard decision. And the hard decision is give that plant the same amount of time you give all the rest of the plants. And if that plant isn't doing as well as the rest of them, basically an average in your grow room, take that plant and get it out of there. Just don't even look at it, throw it away, cut it, and just focus on the plants that are going to deserve your attention, because just a little bit of attention to them, you're going to once again reach the highest potential of that plant and your grow that year. And four is really probably the golden nugget in all four of these suggestions. Although, like a diamond that has not been discovered in the earth, you have to dig toward it before you can find out what's important. Same thing with this. You cannot get to this one part without putting these first three things into practice first. So the fourth thing is start with what your plant is most exposed to first and improve that. And what I mean by that is, let's say you live in a really hot area. Well, if your plants are being beat down by the sun every single day, I would suggest don't go out and buy really nice nutrients. Go out and buy a shade cloth so your plants will have some level of shade on the hottest time of the day. And if you do that, that's going to make more of a difference than any nutrients you ever buy. Why is that? It's because on a day in and day out basis, your plant is being exposed to the sun for anywhere from 12 hours to 16 hours out of the day. So for literally half to three quarters of the day, your plant is being exposed to some element. For watering or nutrients, you might be feeding your plant once or twice a week. I hope you kind of understand what I'm saying when I point out exposed. So second thing, wind. I give you my word, if your plant is in an environment where the wind is blowing every single day, that's going to have more of a detriment on your plants than, once again, all the fertilizer you can give it. So that would be the next thing I'd probably suggest. Put up something that's going to be blocking the wind and diffusing it away from your plant, so your plant has more time to grow versus needing to put more cellulose around the stem so that it could survive the harsher wind. What we're talking about is increasing your yield and quality by removing the things that your plant has to overcome so that the plant itself can put more energy and time into producing flower and fruit. I know I'm not giving you a lot of specifics in this video, and I'm talking more about the mindset of the grower, because just like how Jesus Christ said, give a man a fish, feed him for a day, teach a man how to fish, feed him for the rest of your life. And that's what I'm doing in this video. I'm hoping to give you a couple suggestions around your mindset and your daily disciplines on your approach to growing your plants. Thank you so much. Please give me a thumbs up and share and subscribe if you aren't to the channel. Have a great grow, everyone.